Hello students, so we are again back with our 12th class poem, second poem, An Elementary School Classroom in a Slum. So first two stanzas we have already done, and in the second stanza, the poet said that these school classrooms are decorated with certain things which come through donations. Now whether these things are of use or not for these primary school children, but these things are hung. Now we come to the third stanza, what he says further. He says, surely Shakespeare is wicked, the map a bad example, with ships and sun and love tempting them to steal. Here he is talking about Shakespeare, but it doesn't mean that he is talking about only one writer. He is generalizing actually. Though he is using this name because Shakespeare's portrait is hung in the classroom. That's why he is talking about this Shakespeare only. Here he says these writers like Shakespeare, who write great books, they are evil. They prove to be evil. They prove to be bad for these slum children. And in the same way, this world map, which tells that the world is so big, actually this is also very bad example for them. Now why these writers and world map bad for them? Because he says, when these slum children, they read the stories, they read the books written by these great writers, they get to know through these books the beauty of the world. Ships and sun, they get to know that the world is so beautiful, having water bodies, having good ships, they read about the great voyages, and then they read about the beauty of sunrise, they read about the beauty of the sky, then they read about love stories. They read about romance. Actually, all these things are not there in these slum children, in the life of these slum children. But when they read all these things, so they are transported into a dreamland. And they start dreaming, wishing to lead that kind of luxurious life, which is not possible. And then what happens? As a result, because they need money to lead this kind of life, so as a result, they don't mind go for stealing. They become, it means, thieves. And poet feels that maybe because of these great books and the example of this world map, these children get those desires, and sometime just to fulfill those desires, they become thieves also. So that's why for this poet, these things are bad for slum children. For lives that slyly turn in their cramped holes from fog to endless night. He says that this is the irony, that when they are reading the story, they are transported into some other land, land of fantasies. But when the story finishes, the irony is that the reality brings back them to the slums only. Means the life stealthily, slyly takes a turn, and they are back in their slums. And these slums are cramped holes. Though in the stories they are dreaming of palatial houses, but the reality is that their houses are very small. The rooms are like small holes. Cramped means very congested houses, and the rooms are like small holes. And their life is very foggy. Their life is very unclear, very uncertain. He says their life starts from fog and it goes unto to the night only. It ends with the night. Means for them maybe there is no bright morning. So this is the reality, but in the books they lead some other kind of life. So that's why he says these books, these writers are bad for them. On their slag heap, these children wear skins peep through by bones. And then he says, what is the condition of the slum? He says the slums are very dirty places, very narrow lanes, and these lanes are having dirt and garbage scattered here and there. And these children, because they are not allowed to go and play in the playgrounds, they are not allowed to enter into the towns. That's why they play in these lanes only, dirty lanes only. They play on these garbage heaps only. And then what kind of children they are? These children wear skins peep through by bones. And here he's trying to say that these children are malnourished. They are so slim, they are so thin, It seems sometimes as if the bones are coming out of their bodies, coming out of their skin. So it means they are so thinny people, very skinny people they are, skinny children they are. And then he says, and spectacles of steel with mended glass. Firstly, he talks about malnutrition, and then he is now talking about the condition of poverty. He says they are so poor that they cannot even arrange their spectacles if they need it. He has taken one example of spectacles because he feels that if somebody's eyesight is weak, he cannot do without spectacles. He needs to purchase it. But here he says, for these things also they don't have money, because this is not a luxury. Okay, this is the necessary thing, but even then they don't have that much money to purchase the spectacles even. And from where they arrange these spectacles from the garbage only. Means some rich people might have discarded, might have thrown, maybe because of the frame is out of fashion or something else. So these children, they just take it from the garbage heap, and then maybe they get it repaired or little bit with mending, they start using these spectacles. So this shows the extent of poverty, like bottle bits on stones. Then he says, these children, their life is very scattered life. There is no certainty for future. There is no certainty for tomorrow. And he has taken the example of this. He says, if we throw some bottle on a stone, what will the condition of the bottle? It will break into small pieces. And he says, these children's, these slum people's life is like that, scattered bits of glass. So he says, he's trying to say that there is no certainty in their life. Okay, so they have very scattered life. All of their time and space are foggy slum. And he says, actually, these slum children, we can say throughout, means their future is also slum only. Okay, throughout their life, they lead this kind of miserable life. Their all time, their whole life is miserable. So blot their maps with slums as big as dooms. And he says, their slums are compared to here dooms. Dooms means hell. So he says, they lead a hell-like life over here. And so blot their maps. Maybe, and symbolically, he's trying to say that their maps, actually map of their future is always blotted by these, we can say, dirtiness in their life. Okay, means their life, the future of their life is blotted one. Okay, so he says that there is no future, no clear future, nothing for tomorrow, and their life is like hell. One more, we can say, meaning we can take for this last line. So blot their maps with slums. So he says, if we are to put an indication, a dot, just to show on the world map that wherever it is slum area in the world, so if we are supposed to put a dot only, then maybe the whole world map will be full of dots. The whole world map will be blotted. So now he's trying to say that this is, naturally, these are the blemishes. Okay, he's trying to say that slums are the blemishes on the face of world map. And then in the last stanza, now he's appealing to do something for these slums so that these blemishes can be washed away. So we come to the last stanza. Unless Governor Inspector Vister, he has done this only. Now he's appealing these people. Governor means somebody representing government. Inspector, somebody representing the education department. Sometime in the government school, especially, the inspectors come to inspect. So he's talking about education department. Then visitor. Visitor means somebody who is very rich, who can have spare money, okay, to help these poor people, to adopt these poor people and do something for their future, for their bright future. Now he says, unless until these people who have access, so if they only extend their helping hand, then only we can expect some betterment in their life. So in a way, actually, he's hoping. In a way, we can say he's appealing these people to take a step forward, to extend helping hand, so that there should be some help for these poor children, poor slum children. He says, unless and until they come forward, you cannot expect any betterment. He says, if they come forward, then only this map becomes their window. He says, if they get some kind of help, then only the map, which is word map, which is hung on the wall, can take place of the window map. Now, what is window map? We have already done window map. Why this window map word is used? Because these slum children, they see their slum through the window. Okay. And they have not seen the world beyond that. So for them, this is the world which they see through the window. But he says, if somebody comes with the helping hand, then maybe for these slum children also, this map which is hung on the wall can take place of this window map. Okay, then only maybe they will forget looking at their slums. This map becomes their window, and these windows that shut upon their lives like catacombs. And he says, these windows, what are these windows? Windows means dirty life. Okay, windows means the cramped holes, houses. Okay, so these are the windows, because this is slum life only. He says, these slums which are actually shutting their life, which are closing their life, which are putting an end to their future. Okay, and he has used the word catacombs. Actually, what is catacombs? Catacombs are underground graves. He says, actually, in the slums, their life is no better than graves. Now, why he has taken this example of graves? Actually, in the grave, there is only darkness. Okay, when somebody is put under the grave, it means he cannot see the sun. Okay, there is no light over there. There is only darkness. And he says, actually, these slums have shut their lives, shut the doors of future to them. Their life is full of darkness in the slum. And that's why he says, somebody should come forward with helping hand. Break, oh, break open till they break the town. And then he's again appealing. He's appealing to the authorities, and he's trying to request them. He's requesting them that please break all the barriers which you have put for these slum children. Because these slum people are not allowed to enter into the town to enjoy the, we can say, the luxuries of life, even to lead a normal life like other people. And now here he's appealing. He says, please break all the barriers. Whatever hindrances you have put for these children of slums, please break all these barriers. So break or break open till they break the town. Till they break the town doesn't mean that they are supposed to break the town. Here means till they enter into the town and start leading normal life like other children. So break all those barriers which are posing hindrances for them. And show the children to green fields and make their world run azure on gold sands. He says, let these children, means give them freedom, and let these children see the green fields, see the greenery. Because we have already read that they have never seen greenery, they have never seen beauty of nature, because they never go beyond their slum. But here he says, please allow them to see the greenery, and then make their world run azure on gold sand. Azure means blue, vast sky. Let them run on the shore, seashore. Let them run on the sand. Let them from there see the vast sky, because from their slum in the narrow lanes, they have never got chance to look at the blue sky. So let them now look at the beauty of the sky. And let their tongues run naked into books. Here, let their tongues means let them express freely. Means let them speak. Do not put any, we can say, barrier on their tongue also. Do not stop them to express themselves. Give them freedom. Okay, so that they can express freely. Run naked into books means give them freedom. Run naked means let them be free to read whatever book they want to read. Okay, it's not that they are slum children, so they should not be reading big books, or they should not be reading books written by big people. No, let them read whatever they want to read, even books written by great writers. So they should also access, they should also have access to these books. Run naked into books, the white and green leaves. So white and green leaves can be maybe the beauty of the whole world. Every kind of beauty. Okay. So the white sand, the white waters, or maybe the snow covered areas or greenery. So all these things we can say are covered in these two words. So this writer is trying to say that please let them enjoy the whole world. Every kind of beauty. Okay. White and green leaves open means let's open everything for them. and then history theirs whose language is the sun. And then he ultimately says, actually, this is a proof in the history. You can go to the history and you can see that whose names are shining in the history. Whose names are shining like sun? Those who have great words. Okay, history theirs whose language is the sun means those who have control over language, who have hold over language, or who have good words with them means who have good knowledge. Okay, so let them read, get them gain knowledge so that they also shine in history. Okay, so this is now, I think, let's have a recap in Hindi. So ये राइटर क्या बताने की कोशिश कर रहा है, उसने स्लम के बच्चों के लिए थोड़ा कंडीशन उनकी जो उसको देख के थोड़ा सा उसको बुरा लगता है, और वो अपने पोएट्री के थ्रू गवर्नमेंट से अपील कर रहा है कि इन स्लम चिल्ड्रन के लिए कुछ करा जाना चाहिए. फर्स्ट पैराग्राफ में वो स्लम के बच्चों का हालत बताता है कि वो भूखे सुबह स्कूल के लिए आते हैं, इसलिए उनका मन स्कूल में नहीं लगता. लड़कों को या लड़कियों को, सबको अपने घर जाके बहुत सारे काम करने हैं. इवन बॉयज को तो शायद बहुत भूख लगी है, वो खा ही नहीं पाते सुबह, उनके पास होता नहीं है, और वो पढ़ने के लिए भेज दिए जाते हैं, इसीलिए उनका पढ़ने में मन नहीं लगता. फिर वो सेकंड स्टेजा में बताता है कि इनके क्लासरूम को कोशिश की गई है डेकोरेट करने की, लेकिन उन चीजों से जो शायद उनके मतलब की नहीं है. अच्छी अच्छी सीनरी लगा दी जाती है, उन्होंने कभी सीनरी देखी ही नहीं. उनको अलाउड ही नहीं किसी पार्क में एंटर करना, और आप बड़े बड़े पीक्स की स्नैप लगाते हो या अच्छी ट्रीज की स्नैप लगाते हो, उससे उनको कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता क्योंकि उन्होंने देखा ही नहीं. वर्ल्ड मैप क्लास में टंगा हुआ है, लेकिन उन्होंने कभी मैप क्या देखना, उन्होंने उनको लगता है कि दुनिया सिर्फ स्लम है, इसलिए उनको वर्ल्ड मैप समझ नहीं आता. फिर वो थर्ड पैराग्राफ में कहता है कि वो बुक्स जब वो पढ़ते हैं, अगर उनको पढ़ने को दे दी जाती हैं, तो शायद कभी कभी ये बुक्स उनके लिए गलत सिद्ध हो जाती हैं. क्यों? क्योंकि इन बुक्स को पढ़ने के बाद वो थोड़े ख्वाबों वाली दुनिया को चाहने लग जाते हैं, जो शायद मुश्किल है बिना पैसे के, और इसलिए कभी कभी वो चोरी भी करने लग जाते हैं. और कहता है अगर आप उनके एरिया में जाओ तो आप देखोगे हर तरफ गंदगी है, और उनके लिए बहुत मुश्किल होता है उस तरह की जिंदगी में आगे बढ़ना. इसीलिए आखिर में वो कहता है कि प्लीज जिनके पास पैसा है, या गवर्नमेंट के लोग या एजुकेशन मिनिस्ट्री के लोग, प्लीज वो आगे बढ़े और इन स्कूलों की हालत देखें, इन बच्चों की हालत देखें, और उनके लिए कुछ करें. फिर वो कहता है कि जो रिस्ट्रिक्शन इनके ऊपर हमने लगाई है, जो हम इनको फायदे नहीं देना चाहते हैं, जो हमें लगता है कि ये तो स्लम के बच्चे हैं, इनको नहीं चाहिए ये सब चीजें, कहता नहीं, इनको भी चाहिए. इनको भी बुक्स पढ़ने दो, इनको भी लाइब्रेरीज जाने दो, इनको भी दुनिया की ब्यूटी देखने दो. कहता क्योंकि इनके पास भी वो मौके आने चाहिए कि ये नॉलेज गेन करें और अपना नाम दुनिया में रोशन करें. आई थिंक यू माइट हैव अंडरस्टूड. सो आई मस्ट से टेक 2-3 रीडिंग्स एंड यू विल अंडरस्टैंड इट. थैंक यू.